And we're joined by Matt Daneman, business reporter for the Democrat and Chronicle. Good to see you again this week.
Happy spring, Julie.
Oh, nice tie, too.
Why, thank you.
Perfect for the occasion. Kodak and its retirees face off in court.
Yeah, you had earlier this week, you had one of the omnibus hearings that has been sort of monthly throughout Kodak's Chapter 11 process since it started January 19th, filing for Chapter 11. And what you had, interestingly, this week down in New York City was perhaps one of the first motions that really has a big, big ripple effect on a lot of Rochester area population. Kodak was seeking to have, as we talked about previously on the show, seeking to basically eliminate coverage, sort of supplemental, not a Medicare supplement, but a Medicare Advantage plan it provided for Medicare-eligible retirees ages 65 and older, retired after 1991. While the bankruptcy court so far has been pretty lockstep with Kodak in improving all sorts of things Kodak has sought, elimination of this contract or that contract or hiring this party or that party, this one, Judge Gropper in bankruptcy court put a sort of a hold on this motion by Kodak and in essence told the company, we can take a look at changing retiree benefits, but first there ought to be creation of some kind of official retiree committee to represent retirees and their voices in this whole process, which really makes it for an interesting dynamic and could make for an interesting dynamic going forward. All a bankruptcy is in a lot of ways a big negotiation with all these various parties sitting around the table, all with the same goal in mind of how we want to get the best returns we can for our cash or get the
and
best guarantees.
Other corporations have their lawyers, and
exactly.
Although I'm sure there are some smaller businesses that are in a similar situation to
and
retirees.
All the unsecured mm-hmm. creditors have their own representation. For retirees to have their own representation, their own seat at the table, that really elevates their status in this whole process much greater than it had been. It looked for a while like retirees could be in the same boat as stockholders and basically whatever scraps might be thrown to them as they sit at the feet mm-hmm. of the table like a puppy, you know, that's the best they're going to get. This really could elevate their standing and give them a lot better shot at having some benefits coming out of this, some guaranteed benefits. It seems unlikely that they're going to walk away from Kodak's Chapter 11 process having the exact same benefits and coverage they do now. But if they still maintain something, mm-hmm. they're better off than they would have been.
No, I'm sure they're very relieved at this point. What's the process for putting the committee together, and when will this be back in court?
Right now, the judge indicated, and there was all sorts of testimony and talking in court, that there's been sort of unofficial talks with ECRA, the Kodak Retirees Group. The judge seemed to be emphasizing if you can voluntarily put together a retiree committee, that would be great. If not, the court obviously has the ability to create one officially, and then members would be appointed. The hope is that there's supposed to be a hearing scheduled on this sometime between now and mid-April. Last I checked, it had not been scheduled as yet. But this thing is moving around very quickly. We're not talking where June, July, August, there'll be the next activities. We're talking days, couple weeks.
All right. Next up, a retail development in Greece gets the go-ahead.
Yeah, Kamaita this week gave the stamp of okay to some property tax breaks, mortgage tax breaks, a variety of tax breaks on a pretty big retail development for the Rochester area. So it was a sizable sort of thing, roughly $52 million. We're talking on Ridge Road right by Elm Grove. It's a DeMarco project, and this will be an expansion of the retail development they already have there, such as the Kohl's and that whole plaza. Mm-hmm. The notable thing is you're really seeing this growth of Ridge Road and sort of the retail expansion of it. This plaza that the DeMarco Group is pushing for, the $52 million project, they're talking about breaking ground and starting the construction later this year, sort of in the last quarter of 2012. And obviously there's also a planned development by another developer right across Ridge Road from this that has been in some sort of legal back and forth with DeMarco about extension of utility lines and such. We really could be seeing a lot more retail growth on Ridge Road in that area.
What's driving that, especially the economy hasn't quite turned the corner.
You know, it's interesting. At the same time, the economy hasn't turned the corner, but the scruple, the penny pinching that the retailers, or I should say the shoppers, that the shoppers have shown last couple of years is really starting to loosen. People are spending more. Mm-hmm. People are saving less. They're putting less money towards their credit cards and spending more again. So you're seeing the spigot of cash
developers
towards retail.
Developers are ready to take
and developers
from
ready
them.
To jump on
that.
Okay,
a little bit of time left. We have Windstream getting ready to break ground.
Yeah, you may remember in the misty shades of past, we would talk about Paytech and its plans.
I do remember the misty shades.
Way
yes.
back in the Wayback Machine. Windstream is supposed to break ground. Well, actually, technically, the Pike Company is supposed to break ground just this Monday on the Seneca building, on the redevelopment of that. Windstream, when it's all said and done, Windstream is expecting to rent two-thirds of that building, move about 300 some of the Paytech employees they picked up last year when they bought Paytech into that building, and thus sort of putting the cap on this whole issue of some former Paytech employees moving to downtown Rochester. Mm-hmm. Obviously, it's a far smaller project than Paytech originally had pegged of 1,000 people and this mammoth tower that maybe would put the Xerox
jumbo
tower,
screens
jumbo and screens and all that. But at the same time, mm-hmm. it's better than zero people moving downtown to this big leveled plan. Groundbreaking is supposed to be Monday morning. Pike Company develop and make the building, and Windstream being a tenant, and then Pike will be looking to lease out the other third if you're looking for a really big of apartment of about 300,000 square feet.
Just a couple of seconds. Construction starting, when will people be moving in?
Last I knew that the time frame is still by end of 2013, midpoint 2013, that the Windstream folks moving in. Obviously, we'll get updated numbers on that when Pike does their little song and dance ceremony on Monday.
Okay, well, I'm sure you'll have a good time. Thank you so much for coming in today, Matt.
Always a pleasure.
Matt Daneman, business reporter for The Democrat and Chronicle. And I'm WXXI News Director Julie Philipp. Thanks for being here for this edition of Need to Know Rochester. Have a great week.